Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, Day 17 of my Let's Clash series. So currently I'm going to do an attack, attacking this Tower 8 with a lot of resources, not too much as in like 300 over 1000, but I started the morning off by attacking this relatively easy and also decent amount of loot Tower 8. So going ahead with the attack, spreading my troops around the whole entire base, just deploying my clan castle too, containing the wizards as usual. So thanks to my clanmates who have given me and also tolerate my donation ratio, and also my donation ratio is usually 0-0 because my troops level are pretty low. So really thanks to them and also hope they don't mind. And of course I've been donating a lot to them last time when I used my main account. So with this sub account that I'm playing currently, I'm unable to donate because I only have level 3 archers. Once my archers reach to like level 5, then I'll start to donate to my clanmates. So yeah, thanks to them. So yeah, back to the raid. So as you can see, it's going pretty well. Got relatively a lot of the gold and then eventually get the 1-star. So ending the raid and going ahead with the second attack against this Town Hall 7. So usually in the mornings, I don't search for loot as long because I usually am rushing for time going out this and that. So I do not spend my time searching for loot as long when I'm in the afternoon or at night when I'm at home. So in the morning, I usually just go to work, travel to work, and then before I actually leave the house, I'll try to do an attack. And then before I actually go into the office, I will also do an attack. So this is basically how I actually farm my base, how I actually play my clash. And then eventually, once during lunchtime, I'll play a bit too. And then of course, at night, then I will focus really a lot farming hardcore. Sometimes even boosting and of course doing a lot of attacks. So last time when I was still playing my main account, when I was having a lot of time in the military doing admin work, I could play relatively the whole day, so from like morning all the way till night, because work wasn't a lot, definitely one. But when work comes in, work definitely comes in first. So I will have to stop playing Clash and focus on the work, because work is definitely more important rather than just playing a game. So Clash definitely is just a game, although to me and also a lot of people, it's like a lifestyle in a sense that it's a part of your life whereby you can treat this as just one part of your life whereby you enjoy it while you still go ahead with your life. And enjoying it, just playing it as how it go, not taking it as a stressful game or whatsoever. I mean, a lot of people, they just take that as if it's very time consuming, very stressful game to play. However, I don't feel so, and a lot of my clash mates, especially my clan mates, they do not feel so that way too. Especially they just take it as if it's just a small little part of their life, enjoying the game and also having fun, making friends, communicating with them. When they come online, they also say good morning to each other and then wishing each other a good best of luck, and also saying how we are at work, this and that. So it's like another form of communication, rather than having like a group chat on another social media like a WhatsApp or line chat. So Clash to us is like another form of communicating whereby we could have a group chat, a clan chat in fact, and we could actually play a game together, discuss on strategies, etc. So some people take it as if you are still playing a game or whatsoever. I mean, you could take it as if you are socializing with your clanmates, your friends, this and that. And to some people, they will say that, oh, clanmates, some of them, I have not met them before, they are just online friends. But yeah, most of my clanmates, I've met them before, especially in SG Gladiators and also in Mega Empire Asia. So yeah, they are pretty much my real life friends really. So going ahead with the raid, so now going ahead with this 320,000 gold and 320,000 elixir. Seeing that this is a Tower 7 base, I knew that it would be relatively easy to get a 1-star. Otherwise, I'll just keep losing attacks. So for farming, usually we win some and lose some as mentioned in my previous episode. So this one, I definitely wanted to win it. And a lot of the resources were inside the gold mines and also the elixir pumps, which were all just behind the wall. So just breaking through the wall with my barbarians, and then eventually the archers just shooting over the wall, dropping my clan castle, which the wizards came out and just took out the gold mines really quickly, just taking a few shots, and they just went down supporting behind other archers. So as you can see, the wizard their range, they are actually shorter than the archers. So it'll be barbarians in front tanking the damage first, after that followed by the wizards shooting over the barbarians, and then the archers will be behind the wizards. That's why usually wizards get taken out earlier than the archers unless a mortar shell were to come and then eventually take out the whole entire gang. However, the wizard having a higher hit points won't go down as compared to the archer. So now after getting the one star, I'm just waiting for the archers to just do a little bit more damage to the gold mine, stealing a little bit of the gold as I still need gold for my next few upgrades and getting the one star 55%. Going ahead with the next attack with 208,000 gold and 196,000 elixir. So this is a tower 8 and it's not an easy base to budge because a lot of the defenses are inside and behind the walls. So to get a 1 star on this base, you have to break your way into the wall, otherwise the percentage from the outside structures won't be enough to get the 1 star. And I didn't have any wall breakers with me as my wall breakers are pretty low in level. I might start to use them soon in my next few episodes, hopefully be able to get them to like level 4 or in fact level 5. Level 5 will be totally nice. That's the minimum level I plan to get them before I start to use them actually. But I might use them soon as I technically would need them for this kind of raids. Barbarians, they are still very low in level to break through the walls fast enough. So going ahead with the bottom, dropping my clan castle, the wizards coming out to just do a little bit more damage. Stole all the loot from this base, 0 gold and elixir and also dark elixir left for this guy. Tried to take out the 2 builder's hut with 1 lightning spell, with only level 2 lightning spell and it couldn't go down. So that was a lightning fail. So it's okay, we lose some and win some as mentioned. So going ahead with this attack on this Tower 7 again. A lot of elixir, 450 over 1000. So definitely not my base that I want to attack, but the gold was juicy enough for me to go ahead with it. Because my elixir on the top right, as you can see, is at the cap, almost at the cap already. So I didn't need the elixir as desperately as compared to the gold. So it's okay, the gold is going to fill up soon in just a few more raids. And then eventually just waiting for my troops to just continue to clear out the base. Don't think I would be able to score 1 star for this because a lot of my troops went down from the outside and the defenses took them out really quickly. So yeah, I had to sacrifice this attack. And just going ahead with this next attack, with just needing another 140,000 gold before our gold reaches the cap. So 320,000 gold available with a level 12 gold mines on the left side. So just focusing on the gold mines a little as I can, as now the gold has already reached the cap. Didn't really need too much gold, but I decided to use all my troops because I still had like an hour or 1.5 hours left till my builder will be free. So in the end, I just used up all my troops, try to get all the loot and also try to get the 50%. So now it's at 40%, just waiting for my troops to do a little bit more damage and hopefully a miracle would happen. However, they did prove me wrong and they couldn't get the 50% definitely. So going ahead back to my base, as my elixir storage has just completed its upgrade and then eventually I got a free builder and then I used it to remove the tree. So removing the tree got me 3 gems, which was really nice. Step closer to 1000 gems and then eventually upgrading the walls, spending 1.8 million to upgrade 9 walls to level 7 and then upgrading one more wall to level 7, spending all the 2 million gold because I didn't need gold for my next upgrade, which is the gold storage. Gold storage, they need 500,000 elixir to upgrade. So in the end, I did a few more raids and then carry on with this attack. So as you can see, 201,000 gold available. So for this attack itself, the gold were inside the gold storages because the gold storages, they look really full and also the elixir storages, they were very full. And of course, the dark elixir was inside, but I couldn't collect dark elixir for now because I don't have the dark elixir storage. However, just going ahead with the attack, just clearing the outside structures first, dropping one archer on the outside, clearing those exposed buildings first, eventually dropping my troop in a V-shaped manner on the bottom, and then dropping my clan castle with the wizards coming out to do a huge damage to all the defenses, and then just breaking through the wall with my barbarians and also the archers helping out a bit. And then finally, the troops have just broken in, wizards taking out the storages really quickly, archers supporting behind, eventually the 2 gold mines that are being attacked and then eventually the gold has all been taken out, stealing all the gold from the gold storages, left 1000 gold which is actually inside the town hall. Town hall do contain a little bit of gold for those of you who do not know, depending on what town hall level you are and also your opponent is, then there's a loot penalty to that too. So going ahead with the next attack, this attack was pretty high in loot too, 238,000 on this Town Hall 7. So deploying my troops in a rather random fashion because I was a little rushing for time. That's why I didn't record this. That's why it's not a live attack, it's a replay. So going ahead and then stealing all the gold from the gold mine, just left with 7,932 gold, which I would assume is inside the gold storage. So I just decided to just end the battle, as I couldn't see any way that my troops could get the 1 star. So I decided to end the battle with 47% losing the attack. And then eventually I found this Town Hall 9 with 354,000 gold available. And a lot of the gold were inside the gold mine. However, that's not all that is in the gold mine. Some of them were inside the gold storages too. So as you can see on the top over there, between the mortar and also the wizard tower, the gold storage is pretty filled. So I knew that some of the loot would be inside the gold storages. However, I didn't want to go for it because I wouldn't have enough troops to go for the gold storages. At the same time, the splash damage buildings such as the wizard tower and also the mortar will take out my barbarians and archers really quickly. So I just focus on the gold mine, just taking one of the gold mine out, and I'll get like roughly 50,000 gold already. So the last gold mine on the top of there, I was trying my best to and hoping that my troops will actually take it out. However, the wizards were going down really quickly by the damage of the cannon and also the archer tower on the left side. So they went down pretty fast, and then eventually I couldn't get it. So going ahead with the next attack on this Town Hall 8, although it's only a Town Hall 8, but with 300 over 1,000 gold available, is really nice, especially when the gold mines, they are at level 12. So level 12 gold mines, they give a lot of loot, especially it being able to stock up a lot of loot. So just focusing on the gold mines, I didn't really bother about the elixirs too much because the elixir was filling up too fast for me. I just couldn't use the elixir to upgrade any stuff right now, other than maybe training my troops. So just hope that I'm able to reach to like Town Hall 8 fast enough so that when I do my next few upgrades and then eventually when I hit Town Hall 9, I'll be able to use the elixir to upgrade the walls to level 9, 10 and subsequently even to level 11. So that's what I'm actually focusing on. So eventually just going back to this attack, as you can see the Barbarian King was being a nuisance again and then dropping my clan castle, which the wizard took out the Barbarian King really quickly, trying to get the Town Hall so that I didn't lose the attack. So got the Town Hall with the help of the wizards, ending the raid, scoring the 1 star, 30%. So going ahead with the next attack, this attack on the Town Hall 7, 150,000 gold. So this particular attack wasn't too easy to attack because I was thinking whether to go for the gold or go for the win or whatsoever. So in the end, I just focused my troops onto the gold mines on the bottom left, more towards the left side because there was a gold mine there. And the top right there was one isolated gold mine. So I went for it too, dropping a clan castle on the top left, trying my best to get the 1 star. However, I didn't see that it was possible, but just let my troops run about, hoping that it could do a miracle or something for me. Then after that, my wizards, they just took out a bit of the structures. Eventually, they went down really quickly from the damage of the cannon, archer tower, and also the Tesla in the middle. So yeah, I had to sacrifice this attack again, losing the raid. And then eventually this next one, I found this 264,000 gold, which was really awesome on this Town Hall 8. And the gold mines, they were so exposed, and the buildings were so exposed that I could just drop my archers on the outside, sniping the buildings first before I actually proceed on with the main attack. So this is another method that you guys can actually try out, just dropping your archers on the outside, on the outskirts, and then eventually they just snipe out the buildings first before they could actually do a lot of damage. Especially like now, I'm trying to get the percentage high enough first before I break my way through on the left side. So dropping a bit of the archers, getting a bit of the percentages, eventually focusing my troops on the bottom left because the resources were there. And then eventually I focus on the left side because the gold mines were there, and then dropping my clan castle there, trying to take out the gold mines. The gold mines were the main target that I'm looking at. And then once the wizard took a few shots on the gold mines, they went down really quickly. So now at 40% shouldn't be a problem to get a 50%, because the right side there were still some structures that were being taken out by the archers that were sniping at them. So carrying on the attack, we have gotten the 1 star already, and then eventually just ending the battle right here, and then just carrying on back to my base. So back to my base, one of the structures have completed the dark elixir storage, which I'm very sure a lot of you guys want me to farm dark elixir to show you guys how I farm dark elixir, right? So yeah, I've gotten the storage and hopefully be able to farm some dark elixir tomorrow or the following day if I'm free tomorrow, then I'll show you guys tomorrow. Other than that, I will still be focusing on my walls, so I'll be focusing a lot on the gold. Not too much concern about getting the Dark Elixir to get my Barbarian King, because I'm not really too concerned about getting the Barbarian King at this point of time. If it's the Archer Queen, then I will actually focus to get the Archer Queen, because the Archer Queen is a more important hero as compared to the both of them. But yeah, if the Archer Queen is available at this Town Hall level, I would definitely go for her. But she's only available at Town Hall 9, so probably I'll be focusing more on the Dark Elixir once I reach to Town Hall 9, so that I could farm the Dark Elixir for the Archer Queen. So going ahead to get some more of the traps definitely they do help to protect against your base, but of course when they go off, you have to rearm them. Rearming them would cause gold. So that's why I do not try to put them all together. Otherwise, when people try to activate all the bombs and they do not work as well, then I sacrifice all the gold. So usually I try to spread them out. And also it's more efficient to spread them out. So yeah, that's it for this particular episode that I'd like to show you guys. I'll try to show you guys my gold grab and also my elixir escapade, as to let you guys see the progress of how they actually increase as time passes, so that you guys can get a hang of it as to see how fast I'm actually farming. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.